Beg your pardon, but could I trouble you to turn over your weapons? I'm afraid those are the rules. My deepest apologies for the slightest inconvenience, but we simply can't have anyone waving their weapons around in the... Please.
Those cons got the hint. We've shown everyone that these are...
Beg your pardon, stranger, but I'm looking for someone. You ain't seen a young man with dark brown hair and a white hat on lately, have you? Ain't nobody got one darn piece of news about my boy. Not one lousy speck of information. Ain't got one Brahmin unaccounted for across... Yep, got a whole mess of Brahmins to my name. Bighorners, too. Used to just have the one ranch, but land was easy to grab before the soldiers moved in. Before I knew it, I was running one of the big... Now everywhere I go, folks I never... My boy, Ted, he was right here. I didn't leave him but a minute. I told him to stay put while I talked some things over with the White Glove folks. He was never one to stay tied down to a spot, though. Gets that from his mother. Got most of my staff out looking for him now. I'd be out myself, but I keep hoping he'll show up back here. Of course, if he does that, I'll whoop him till his skinny hide turns to leather for putting me through this. But that don't mean I wouldn't be grateful. I'd be more than happy to have you. Heck, I'll hire anybody with a pair of legs and at least one good eye at this point. There'd be a lot of money in it for you if you can get him back to me safe. And if he ain't, you can bet I'll pay for the names of the sons of bitches responsible. That's between me and the White Glove Society. But let's just say they control the food supply around here, and I got lots of food to give. But that ain't as welcome as you might think. That's what they call themselves. Some of them got masks, too.
Our new territories.
Did you know the Strip's all stirred up lately?
Welcome to the Ultralux. I do hope it What else? Mr. Gunderson and I have been discussing his livestock. It's put us in a rather delicate position, you see, his coming here. But our executive chef, Philippe, has transformed Brahmin steak into a delicacy. But a delicacy is just that. And if the gourmand served staples, it would no longer... So as much as we'd all love... This again? I thought this was all... I know our reputation hasn't always been spotless, but that's all in the past now. For the last time, the White Glove Society has never and will never consume human flesh for any reason. Now, didn't I already tell you that we don't do... Though we haven't always been the White Gloves... But that's all changed now. We... You disgust me. How dare you? There was an investigator who came through here last week. He'd been... Well, you can already guess what probably... And that young groom just didn't have a clue. A man? Well, then this... Well, this can't be. I'm going to have a... Whether these people are... Why, yes, I think so, if... I had our maitre d' Mortimer offer him a complimentary... You see? The...
How may I be of service, madam? Private investigator. Ah, yes, I remember the gentleman. This was about the missing bride. Such an awful thing. I do hope he finds her whereabouts. If I might pry, have you found something that will help his investigation? Of course, of course. Now, ordinarily, we don't give out guests. Let's see. He hasn't checked out yet. If you head back... I hope we can...
Did you know the strip's all stirred up lately?
All mine. Come on!
Time for some get even.
Had enough?
Word is, you're getting popular in the strip. Feels good not to have to drag a Brahmin train across the Mojave.
Who are you?
Matchbook? What about the man I gave it to?
Oh my goodness me. They must know he was talking to someone on the inside. They'll be watching everyone closer now. I knew this was a mistake. Mortimer, if he realizes it was me the investigator was planning to meet, he'll have me killed. Yes, the White Glove Society strictly forbids eating humans. But we weren't always the White Glove Society. Mortimer and some of the others have regressed to the old ways. They've taken many people over the last few months, but always from Freeside or secluded places where they wouldn't be missed. It wasn't enough. Lately, they've gone for tourists here on the Strip, even in the hotel.
I guess that's the hazard of a cannibal becoming a gourmet. It's hard to please a refined palate. The girl, the one who disappeared. I know what happened to her. Because I distracted her fiancé while they took her. Well, I'm not proud of it, but I had to. They could see I was having second thoughts. Some of the white gloves began meeting privately a while back, started talking about how we'd lost our identity. I started attending because I thought it was about changing our politics. Then they started talking about returning to the old ways, and there was no way out. They'd kill me for the things I heard them say. He's alive, as far as I know. We're trying to keep him fresh. Mortimer has special plans for him. The White Glove Society has a banquet every night at 7. It's in our private section. Mortimer wants to reintroduce humans into our cuisine. Since eating people is a crime we punish by death, he's going to do it in secret. After everyone has eaten it, he'll tell them. With no real way to punish everyone, in Mortimer's mind anyway, their minds will be open to the idea of eating people as a delicacy. I don't know exactly. I wasn't in on it. I think some of them have stopped trusting me. But you can bet they're keeping him near the gourmand. Our chef, Philippe, has an obsession with fresh ingredients. It'd be back in the members-only section, so you'll have to be careful. Don't be seen, and more importantly, don't let them see Ted in the open. It's guarded both at the lobby entrance and in the access tunnels leading from the main restaurant. I could sponsor you as an honorary member, but I don't know that you've achieved the level of status that would gain the society's approval. Perhaps if you were to gain some more notoriety on the Strip, we could get you in. Otherwise, you'll have to find some way to get inside quietly. It won't be easy, and it'll be harder still to get them out.
Well, they'll all be sampling pre-war wines before the meal. Maybe it's as simple as drugging them. Although, that wouldn't stop any future kidnappings. You'd have to expose Mortimer, but he's going to confess anyway. What if his revelation were a lie? What if no one had eaten human flesh but him? If you could somehow replace Philippe in the kitchen and serve a convincing substitute instead, you could walk Ted right through the middle of that room after Mortimer speaks, and then he'd have some explaining to do. Philippe has been trying to approximate the taste of human flesh for years. He must have a recipe somewhere. Let's plan on meeting again as soon as... Wait, did you hear something? Were you followed?
Have you been in the steam room yet? It's just off to the side there. You can feel your aches just melt away.
What is it? If that's what you think. All right. Guess I'll be around Novak for a while.
Let's hear it. If you're fine, then.
Welcome to the ultralight. Why, yes, of course. It's only now. Originally, we didn't allow. And it has. And the right. I'm afraid you. If you had more notoriety or clout. The answer is still no.
Thank you. My daddy's gonna kill all you bastards once he finds out what you done to me. My daddy sent you? God damn it, I almost died in here. What the hell took you so long? It's just one damn hotel. Who did this to me anyway? What in the Sam hell? Eat me? What kind of sick bastards would eat a person? I'll tell you what, as soon as I'm out of here, and my daddy knows the story, you can bet there ain't gonna be no white hat society no more. To hell with that. You've seen those freaks. They dress the same, talk the same. You can bet they all eat the same, too. They deserve what my daddy's gonna have coming for them. All right, but there's gonna be some justice one way or another. I'll see to that. Let's go. I'll be right behind you. Come on. Come on, move it. Come on, move it.
How may I assist? But no one is in their chairs yet. I'll be ready. How may I assist? At once.
Come on, move it.
I know I'm not the scheduled speaker, but I have a few words, if I may. There was a time, not so long ago, when we were bound together not as members, but as family, as a clan. And when Mr. House came to us with his proposal, we accepted, knowing we stood to gain much. Little did we know how much we'd lose in the process. As a society, we've endeavored to sample the finest food and drink the world has to offer. But we are living a lie. There is a meat sweeter than the most corn-fed livestock. Most of you have tasted it. All of you have coveted it. Among us, it is a crime to discuss a return to the old ways that unified our people. Tonight, that all changes. The taboo ends. Let me finish, Marjorie. You don't know it yet, but you are all now guilty of a greater crime. One that ordinarily bears the harshest of punishments. Surely that you are all guilty warrants not only universal amnesty, but also a renewed discussion. For our society to be truly elite, we must dine on the most delicious, the most exclusive food known to us. And tonight, for the first time as a society, you are sampling that very dish, the meat we are forbidden to taste, the way it was meant to be eaten. Fellow members of the White Glove Society, bon appetit. What the? Who is this trespasser? What are you? Why is he there? Who are we eating right now? No! These are lies. I never kidnapped anyone. And even if I did, there's no harm done. He's alive, after all. You're all hypocrites. How can you claim to be connoisseurs yet deny yourselves the greatest of all meats? I am ashamed to have once called everyone here family. This isn't over, though. I'll begin anew. The White Glove Society will never achieve the greatness of my new order. You'll all hear from me again.
Salutations.
Hello there.
Oh, oh my. How unfortunate. And in front of all these people, too. He always was a bit of a pill, Mortimer. He was so pouty when I decided to ban eating people. And now this. I should have paid more attention to the warning signs. Can you imagine what people would have said? Why, it would have been a complete scandal if it weren't for you.
How do you fare?
Come on, move it.
Greetings.
I am at your service.
Hello.
Hello.
Oh, my God. Ted, are you all right?
Quit your hollering. I'm fine.
You got me my boy back. I got no words. Now, I hope you didn't do no harm to whoever's responsible for this. I want to skin their hides myself. Well, that does it. None of them maniacs will ever do business with Hank Gunderson long as they live. Hell, I'll put me together a damn blockade. They control the food? Well, there ain't gonna be no food. It's a goddamn monument to inhumanity. Let them starve. I don't like this place. Whole strip, really. Ever since I got here, the stink of it has flooded my nostrils. But you got a point. They're already hell-bent on depravity here. All right. Well, I promised you I'd make it worth your while. So here you are. Try not to lose it all at the same casino.